It all starts in Washington, D.C. Before a coin ever becomes a coin, it has to be voted on by Congress. All in favor? Say cha-ching! If Congress thinks it's a good idea and the president approves it, a new coin is authorized for the United States Mint to make. Did you know there are 6 mint locations in the United States? This is an artist at the Mint. He draws pictures of what the coin will look like. If you had to make a coin, what would you put on it? The president? A dog? Maybe the president's dog. See how big we draw the coin? That's so we can sketch all the tiny details. Just think, if the Mint really made coins this big, we'd all have to get bigger pockets. Once we decide on the look of the coin, the sculptors at the Mint will either model the design in a computer or model it in clay. When the clay model is finished, we make a plaster cast of it and sharpen the details. Then, we scan the plaster cast into a computer. This turns the model into computer data. Computer software uses the data to drive cutting tools. The cutter mills the coin designs onto blank hubs that will stamp dies. After that, all the dies are checked. Only the best dies are used to make coins. Then, the Mint feeds big rolls of metal into the side of the machine. Out of the other side, blank metal discs come pouring out. This machine cuts up the scrap. One roll of metal is as long as 5 football fields and can make up to 325,000 blanks. Now it's time to heat up the blanks to make them soft. Then they're cooled. Then they're given a bath. And finally, they're dried off. Look how clean and shiny they are. Or what we like to call minty fresh. The blanks are sent to a machine called the upsetting mill. The upsetting mill raises the rim on both sides of the blank to prepare it for the coin press. Remember the dies we made earlier? They're now inside the coin press. This machine presses the die into the blank metal disc and makes a coin. The new coins are then checked for quality, counted, and put into a jumbo bag. Jumbo bag is then moved by forklift. Then, and taken to the Federal Reserve banks. From there, they will be sent to banks across the country. After that, you spend them on all sorts of stuff, or save them for your very own coin collection. And that's it. Now you know how coins are made. To learn more about how the Mint connects America through coins, or play online games and find lesson plans, visit our website. Thanks for watching.